You like the promise of God. Do you think she will respond with all this dialogue, this type of dialogue going on?
Yeah.
Okay.
That depends.
I told you I was just saying. What do you mean? He says, you know, the guy's throwing his best shot.
Yeah, he's probably thrown in a million times before.
Uh-oh.
I'll leave it at that.
Uh-oh.
It depends on whether she believed it or not.
Uh-huh.
If she's been duped before.
Uh-huh.
May not.
Uh-huh.
But, you know,
yeah.
If she was
open. Mm-hmm. This situation right here, this is the perfect picture of God putting a man and woman together. So this is okay. But we do know Solomon's background.
Yeah.
So did he say this 700 other times?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Is he,
that's what
is he really in love this time?
Yeah.
No.
Is he just moved by the Holy Ghost to write what a true picture of what God says a man and woman should be like?
Maybe this is the first one.
This could be the first one?
Yeah,
it could be. In my Bible, it says, it may be that Solomon's relationship with the Shulamite was the only pure romance he ever experienced. Like Travis was saying, it may be.
Well, if that was the case, the Holy Ghost felt anointed enough, ordained enough to put it in the Bible.
It says the bulk of his marriages were political arrangements.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So this might have been his only real true love. I mean, regardless, this is the picture, this is the process. In God's eyes, this is what it should be like. And I'm thinking that he was really in love here. Because you can't come up with this. This had to be inspired in order for us to have it today. All scripture is given for what? Instructions.
You know, the interesting thing, Brother Williams, as I reflected on this,
Song
of Solomon, I believe, was written after the, you know, it comes after Ecclesiastes. It came after all his experiences with all these other wives and concubines, and then he finally. Isn't that typical of men?
Well, now it's time for something new.
I'll leave it at that.
Okay. Well, just so you know, like I said, when we open up, that this is unique, and in this day and age, we're far from this picture of doing it God's way. We got all other kind of ways, but this is the perfect way that God wants man and woman to come together after a courtship, after a long courtship. And then finally at that wedding day, and then that wedding night, that's what God has designed. But no, you don't have to go far to see that this is not the picture that you see in everyday life. But this is the perfect picture. If you want to be whole emotionally, physically, and connected with your spouse, this is the way you would do it. And this guy, he's stepping, he's on fire. So, ooh, your lips taste like honeycomb. And he's treating her with respect. And he's saying all this good stuff. Honey and milk, under thy what?
Tongue.
How do you know that? He had to get there and figure it out. And the smell of like clothes. Probably holding the bra. To our audience. Smell of your clothes. Whoa. Smell good. It's like the smell of what? Lebanon. Ooh, this brother. He probably taught Barry White to sing. Okay, so we get into, now this is bringing man and woman together. Peter, I believe Paul even said, here's a mystery. Man and woman in love. Here's a mystery. But I believe Paul says, and maybe Peter, I've got my mind, I'm so lavish. My mind. this is like, I think it's Paul in Ephesians. This is like Christ's love for the who?
Church.
Woo! That's how he, when you come to him, that's how he loves up on you. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. And see, then if your head ain't straight, it's all real, but God, you smell that sin on you. No, you don't. He smells that honey and honeycomb. I covenant with you, so he smells what he sees. He's looking at the future. He says, this is what we got going on. Whoa. So, you know, we think about our sin life. Christ is not, Paul says, it's a mystery. This is how great God's love is for you. Did you find that, Candy?
Ephesians
11, right? Ephesians 5 and 25. Yeah. Okay, Ephesians 5, 25, what's it say?
Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. Mm-hmm. You might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
That he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives.
Keep reading to verse 33. Keep reading.
He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as the Lord, the church.
Keep going.
For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. Mm-hmm. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they too shall be one flesh.
Keep going.
This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church.
Okay.
Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband.
Respond back. Respond back. He's giving you all that love and so forth. So here is, so Paul, the New Testament reality says, this is what we're reading in the Songs of Solomon, is giving us light as to this is how God loves you. As a New Testament believer. Mm-hmm. Okay. So, here's this man back into the Song of Solomon, the Song of Solomon, anointed song, ordained song. This is what the Solomon is showing us, and the Holy Ghost is showing, this is the perfect way. Verse 12, a garden enclosed is my sister, as he is saying there that a sister who has kept her virginity. And ain't nobody get this close but me. A garden enclosed is my sister. So he's showing her respect. And then he says what? My what?
My spouse.
Now my wife. A spring shut up. A fountain what?
Sealed.
In other words, nobody has been around this neighborhood but me. And that's God's perfect plan. And you know there's people that are arguing and fuss and fight and everything else, and this ain't the way it goes. This is not reality.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It can't be done this way. Well, how can it be done this way? It's because you have to start instilling this stuff at the age of that baby right there. There's so much going on. And here's the deal. Yeah, here's the deal. Most women today, girls today, don't feel it's an honor to be a what?
Virgin.
Mm-hmm. It ain't happening. Friends, everybody else talk about me. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. They say that they, no, I don't know nothing about sex. You're outcast.
Yeah.
So, you have to have some counterpunch against that culture. Mm-hmm. And the counterpunch is that you are instilling it in your children, boys and girls.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. That it's worth, that it, this is the way, if you want emotional health, physical strength, and happiness and peace, then you stay what God has designed for
us.
Yes,
that's right.
But there's all type of noise and everything that's contrary to this. And you know who's behind it? The devil is, because he wants to mess up God's perfect plan. He wants to pervert. Sex is perverted. It's a bad thing. It's a bad thing. It's an odd thing to see a man and a woman have a romantic dinner. That's odd. Yeah.
You mean that's unmarried?
Yeah, I mean a married couple having a romantic dinner at a kind of like that candlelight dinner somewhere out in public, holding hands on vacation, hugged up together like they just met. That's odd. You don't see all that. I remember when I was young, before the seatbelt laws. My girl used to ride where?
Right next to
you. You don't see that.
Very seldom.
Oh, sorry. So he says, a garden enclosed is my sister. And then, now this guy is, he's checking out her anatomy from head to toe. This guy's tough. Thy plants are in what? Orchard of pomegranates. Now what he's saying here is that this ain't no cheap woman. This is no floozy, no huzzy, or whatever you call them.
Both of them.
Yeah, okay. this is none of that. Mm-mm. This is a quality, first-class sister. And he's saying that, and so what I'm trying to get over to the young folks is that if you save yourself until then, you are quality, quality, quality.
That's right.
And you know, if you're not sleeping around and all this kind of stuff, there ain't nothing wrong with that. Best to be not to be sleeping around and all this kind of stuff, because you got quality, quality. Now some, like I said, people diminish and push it down and throw it away. That a man, you know, for kids these days, a man, male, say that no, I'm not sexually active. How do you think the football team would respond to him?
What's wrong with you?
You know,
okay?
Basketball team. You know,
that's terrible.
So you got all kinds of, so he has to be instilled in them as they come up that, no, this is your strength. Okay, praise God. And, with pleasant fruits and all of this kind of stuff, and to show you how valuable one kept is, look at Mark 14:3. Because some of these spices that's in this 13th verse, you'll see that they were, is that right? 14:3? Yeah, okay. Yeah, someone read that if you will, please.
And being in death, being in the house of Simon the leper, as he sat down at meat, there came a woman having an alabaster box of ointments of spikenard, very precious. And she broke the box and poured it on his head.
That's right. And that's the same thing he's saying that she had over there in our 13th verse. And very precious. Very valuable. Hallelujah. Okay. And then you got the 14th verse. All trees of frankincense, myrrh, and alloys with all the chief spices. I mean, this guy is sniffing around her body from head to toe. She's quality. She's good. Smells good. Tastes good. Wow. So, if, like I said, if I was a class of brothers, I'd have to charge you for going in depth in this. I might as well make some money off of this teacher. So, verse 15, a fountain of gardens, a well of living waters, streams of Lebanon. She's got it going on.
She's got it going on.
And this guy is not just sniffing around, he's also what, talking. Every woman wants to know that she smells good, beautiful. Am I right, sisters?
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful. What's the name of that shampoo? Oh, that's not the shampoo, that's you. Oh. He's got it going on. So, first of all, sister, with respect, my spouse, and then in intimacy, mutual pleasure. That's God's design for his man and his woman, according to Hebrews 13:14. Okay, now, he's putting all this effort out. All this effort, huh?
13:4.
Yeah, Mark 13:4. Putting all this effort out, all this effort out. So, what about the sister? What should she say? Should she just ignore him? Mm. I bet you said that to everybody.
Yeah.
I bet you said that to all the girls. So, here's what we find is that it requires love put out, requires a reciprocating. And we listen to today's society, it's, you know, just a man, he's the aggressor. You're like a dog in heat. You don't care whether she likes him or not. This requires that everybody like everybody. So, gotta respond back. I does the sister, respond back. Verse 16. What does she say to her body?
Awake, O north wind, and come, down south. Blow up on my garden, that the spices thereof may flow out.
Hold up. We can't go no further than this. We got to rate this class. Tell her body to respond to his touch. He's behind my ear. Let him know how that feels. Woo. How else should she just keep quiet? Let this fellow do what he wants to do so I can hear him go home. Get out of here. No. She's telling herself to respond back to him. Because everybody's in charge of their own what? Body. And your body will do whatever you tell it to do. Whatever your mind what tells it to do. So she's telling herself to respond back to him. We are spirit, we have a soul, and we live in a what?
A body.
Body. And the body requires nourishment, fulfillment, and the whole nine yards. And if we think anything differently, we're contrary to God's what? Master plan. And by going along with this master plan, we procreate. Bring in beautiful babies, presidents, all kinds of stuff that make the world better. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, you can say, well, now my body, enjoy this. And it's the devil's mindset that says, tell your body not to respond. Be inhibited. Be inexperienced. You know, be cold. Don't respond back to that man. And then that's when Sister Hill has to go into marriage counseling. Marriage counseling 101. I think we got a class, don't we, Sister Hill?
We do have a class,
but
it's not in session.
It's not in session. Marriage class. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's a good one, too.
Marriage class. That's how we have to have. Shouldn't ever have to have those kind of classes. People will do what? Follow the word. Fall in love like the word says. Fall in love.
You know, the interesting thing as I looked over this was that this was a Shulamite woman.
Mm-hmm.
And it says she was a poor beautiful, mm-hmm. but a country girl. Mm-hmm. The, a dire contrast to all the other
women that he's looking for.
Right.
That's right.
She was set aside.
Right. You know, so a lot of the happiness that we're looking for, the peace that, that we're looking for, God gives it to us, but we, you can't find it in a Cadillac or Mercedes Benz and all like that, big house and all that. It won't get close to fulfilling you.
No,
like God wants you to be fulfilled. Mm-hmm. It doesn't get close. So people try it, mm-hmm. and they try to attract their mates that way. Okay, but that's not the. You know.
No.
It's all poor. Like Sister Hill said, country girl. She told us to respond, that the spices thereof may flow out, that my beloved come into his what?
Garden.
His garden.
Garden.
Yeah, respond so he can even take more of me. Mm-hmm. She threw a cold shoulder on him, and it's over with. You know, but she threw a warm shoulder on him. So he can have more. And just have a ball in my garden. Next class, triple X, triple X.
This should be up to class of young men. I'm glad you emphasized men, because traditionally people have emphasized women, and it's both. Men. And women's, I don't know, I thought it's the perfect time to fall in love. Y'all know old. Sometimes you have to fall in love old, it's okay.
But you got sense, but you don't have a vitality.
It's a different
kind of love. When you're young, ooh, that's new. Wow. Sparks are flying all over the place. Oh, dog. That's in the
it's her birthday.
She got everything in there. A lot of colors.